Right, so I'm just sat outside the X07, and tonight we have Yacht on, and we also have the Casio Kids, and I'm sat with...
Ketil is my name.
And you're the lead singer.
Well, we do a lot of harmony vocals, so we're two lead singers, and we generally just swap around on any instrument, so it's just kind of vague who is who.
Yes, looking at you sound checking there, seeing you swapping around instruments all over the place, that's obviously common practice within Casio Kid.
Yeah, we like to keep everything a little bit loose, you know, just to have some fun on stage and keep things a little bit like sort of improvised. We've had it like that since the beginning, but you know, lately it's become more structured. In the beginning, we didn't even know, you know, we just put up some names of some imaginary songs and we just started jamming basically. But now we actually have some songs.
And so you are from Bergen in Norway?
Yeah, Bergen, West Coast, Norway.
And there's five of you in the band, isn't there? But I understand it's varied over the years.
Yeah, there are five core members, but we've had the maximum number of people on stage has been 33, I think. But then we had a choir and everything. But in general, with only five people, and we collaborate with theatre troupe called Digital Theater, and they do sort of live animations and also shadow puppetry, but they're not with us in Luxembourg.
I've seen some of the YouTube videos, and I recommend people have a look at these videos. And seeing the MySpace site, you've got this video of just jamming, and then there's lots of kids around playing with a microphone and so on like that.
It was from a project we did summer 2007 in Paris city center in a park there, during a festival called Sous la Plage. And what we did was set up a gear in the middle of a playground, and we attached microphones to the different apparatuses around, and we let people, kids come and play with them, and just sort of use the recordings from when they played with the different apparatuses to rhythms that we incorporated in our music. We kind of had the PA system and everything, all the synthesizers and everything in the playground, so we sort of did a concert together with the kids without using language. That was sort of the idea. So how to have an interactive concert in a way. And that's something we've done from the beginning, you know, experiment a little bit with how we present the music. It's always going to be based on the songs we make in the studio, but we've done workshop sound installations and experimented with what we do on stage with this theatre troupe that we have with us. And I think it's been really good for us, making the concert experience a little bit more special.
Talking of language, you do sing in your native tongue, in Norwegian, which for me I quite respect, in the fact that there's a lot of bands who just pander to the English language, and you in fact can claim the first Norwegian language single released in the UK, is that right?
At least a pop single.
Yeah.
I'm guessing there has been some releases, sort of like more traditional Norwegian fiddle music, or maybe some metal releases, but I think it's the first sort of pop release in Norwegian.
Were you surprised at the reaction of the English press, like the Enemy are really behind you, and the Guardian as well, Independent? Have you been surprised with that, or are you just going with it?
I think we all took a chance when we did it, but it was such a new thing that everyone really got into the idea quite quickly, both the magazines, both the media and the audience, and just the feedback has been amazing, especially in the UK. We haven't played Luxembourg before, so we don't know what the feedback will be or has been before in Luxembourg. But yeah, UK has been amazing. And we're going on a 2-week tour there next week as well.
Yes, in fact, you're going to the Great Escape, which is a big old festival for all new bands coming through.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of actually releasing your music, it tends to be a quick turnaround. You release quite a lot of singles. Are you going to do an album at all?
The idea with the singles was also connected to how the music industry has developed, I think. We had our own studio in Bergen. We just decided to release everything quite quickly to keep the concert audience sort of on the same wavelength as us. And therefore we decided to just finish two songs at a time and release them on what our record company is Moshi Moshi in England. And that idea was also something new, sort of an experiment, and also have been really good for us because it kind of keeps the attention on us like quite regularly, since we have small releases all the time. But it also makes it, yeah, like I said, easier for the audience because and us, because when the songs are fresh, the audience, they have actually heard it. So I think that was a good idea, and we might later on do sort of a singles compilation, but for now I think this project works a treat.
You seem to be on a never-ending tour at the moment, and is that the way it's going to go for a while?
We played, I think, the end of May, then we have 100 travelling days and 90 shows in 16 countries. So it's been pretty hectic, but it's been fun as well. You know, who knows when I would be able to visit Luxembourg if it didn't go so well. So it's a lot of fun, and we're really focused on getting to see something in each city. And some cities we spend some more time in as well. We recently spent 2 days in Tilburg in Netherlands, where we have some friends, and we had show the first day, and then the second day we had a party with our friends. So I think it's nice to, when we tour as much as we do, we can actually keep in touch with friends in different cities, you know, like Paris, Amsterdam, and Tilburg and London. So it's easier to, it's more fun to travel around when you're visiting friends different places.
Okay, one more thing is your work with kindergartens. What's that all about?
We actually, you know, the kids in Casio Kids, we kind of fell into that one because it wasn't intentional that we weren't thinking about making music for kids in the beginning. It was just a funny name, you know, attached to the Casio. So, but we got an offer from the local government in Bergen to do a tour in kindergartens because not many bands were doing it, and there was obviously a market for it. So we just did it, and the reaction was amazing. And after that, we just continued doing workshops and concerts for kids, and we just treat them as any other audience, and the same amount of respect. Respect.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and I hope it goes very well tonight.